Hey guys, it's Megan and welcome back to my channel. Recently, I have been getting a ton of questions in the comments of some of my videos, so I decided that I would go ahead and answer a few of them for you and make a little Q&A video. So here we are, and I'm just gonna go ahead and get started. I have them up here on my computer. The first question is, did you have career plans and how did they change after the accident? So when I lost my arm, I was 14, so I didn't necessarily have a career plan. I knew I wanted to wrestle. I was wrestling at the time, and I thought that I wanted to wrestle in college. And so obviously that changed because wrestling became way harder, and I wasn't in a place where I could have received like a bunch of scholarship money like I wanted to. So it kind of sent me on a different path that way. I was also really interested in like hair and becoming like an esthetician before I lost my arm, and so that also kind of changed. But I like to think, nothing against wrestling or estheticians, but I like to think that it changed for the better because I think what I do now suits me. So, all right, question number two is a two-part question. It says, are you able to get a prosthetic or why don't you wear one? So I actually have a prosthetic. I picked it and was fitted for it when I was 15, so right after I lost my arm. And the thing about my prosthetic is at 15, my priorities or the reasons why I wanted an arm were like purely cosmetic. So I opted for the cosmetic prosthesis, which really serves zero function other than making other people feel comfortable. So it honestly was a hassle for me to wear it. It was a hassle for me to have to put clothes on it. And then, you know, in order to wear it, I had to have this huge strap around my chest, and it just was honestly easier to not wear it. So I, you know, adapted to not wearing one, and now I'm so used to not wearing one that it just, I don't see a purpose in wearing one. I think maybe down the road, if technology advances to a point where prosthetics are, because I'm missing my entire arm, so if prosthetics get to the point where they're advanced and lightweight and, you know, actually would serve me a purpose, then I would probably get one. But as of right now, and considering what's on the market, I'm doing okay with just my one real arm. Number three is, how does it feel to have a missing limb? So I can only speak for myself, but the way my missing limb feels is insane. I lost my arm in an ATV accident, which if you've seen my other videos, then you probably know that. But it was 98% amputated. So basically from the time of impact when my arm was basically ripped off my body to now, the feeling hasn't really changed that much. So when I first lost my arm, I remember like telling my friends and the paramedics like, oh, it's a stinger, because it just felt numb. And it's basically felt that way ever since. I would say that there were like two or three times in my life where the way that my arm feels kind of changed. The first time was the morning I woke up from surgery after having the arm actually amputated. So when I got into the hospital, they reattached it. It still felt numb. But then when they finally decided, okay, this arm isn't gonna work. This isn't gonna work out for her. We're gonna take off the arm. The morning I woke up after getting my left arm amputated was probably the most painful it had ever been. So basically it felt like my left arm was still on, it felt like it was still there, but it was in this weird like T-Rex position almost. And as hard as I would try to bring it down, it was just stuck in this position. So eventually that pain subsided, and my arm just kind of went into like anatomical position. But then it did what they call telescoping. So basically what that means is that the brain continues to send signals to the arm, which is called phantom limb. But then when those signals aren't firing and your limb isn't doing what the brain is telling it to do, it shortens the arm in your head. It's the weirdest thing. So I feel like I have my arm. I just feel like it kind of ends at my hip, which is the weirdest thing. Like I have a little tiny arm on my left side, a little lucky fin. So And I have a lot of feeling in my hand, in my forearm, but not so much like my bicep and elbow, but it does still feel like it's laying there, but it's obviously not. So yeah, and in terms of pain, I'm really lucky, and I think it's because I still have my entire brachial plexus was able to be salvaged, so it's actually right on the surface of my skin. And if you ever meet me in person, I'll let you feel it, because it literally feels like a cable or like a phone charger cable. Yeah, like a cable is in my armpit. Weirdest thing ever. So when I touch on the nerve right there, it feels like I'm touching my left hand, which is just wild. Okay. All right, moving on. How old are you? I just turned 23 yesterday, actually. Pisces season. Shout out to all my fellow Pisces. What is phantom pain? I kind of explained that in question number 3, so I will move on. Do you use your feet a lot since you lost your arm? And the answer to that is no. I personally don't. Sometimes I'll use my feet to like open a Gatorade bottle or a water bottle, but not really a foot user. That was one thing when I watched Soul Surfer, which I don't know if any of you have seen that, but the girl who played Bethany Hamilton's character used her feet to cut an orange, and I think I had lost my arm like 2 years prior to that premiere. Okay, how do you curl your hair with one arm? In my How I Lost My Arm video, I show you guys how I do kind of like a little twisted bun, and that's just normally how I curl my hair. I can curl my hair. I'll just like part it. I part it in sections, and then I just grab it. I can't use a wand, obviously, so I get like the curling iron with the clamp, and then I twist it around. But you know, your hair tends to like do that, and then it's not clean curls, so I usually just twist it into a bun and pull it out when it's dry, and it gives me nice beach waves. When you get your nails done, do they charge full price? A lot of people ask me this question, and the answer is no. They don't. I get half price manicures, major plus having one arm. But it's funny, I'll go to get my nails done, and the nail techs like don't ever look up at me, so they'll just like be working on one hand, and then they won't even look up, and they'll like ask for my other hand, and then they'll look up at me and be like, they definitely reassure me that I'm getting half price after they do that, because they always feel really bad. But question 9 is, what was the first thing you thought of when you lost your arm? The first thing I thought of when I lost my arm was I was nervous, because there was a rock lodged into my head right here, and I was on the ground, and so there was like blood in my face, so I was just kind of worried about my head, like I didn't really know what it looked like. But then once the paramedics got there, all I could think about was not my physical condition but my clothes, because they had to cut my clothes off of me to assess the damage that had been done. And I remember being in like all new clothes I had just gotten for Christmas. So I had like this Ed, it was 2009, so don't judge me, but I had this Ed Hardy belt on and like $200 jeans and a North Face, like my nicest clothes, which I don't know why I would have worn those mudding, but I did. So yeah, that was my main concern when I lost my arm. Okay, moving on. Question number 10 is, how long did it take for you to get comfortable doing tasks with one arm? I would say probably 2 years. I think the first year, you know, it's kind of a learning curve, because I wanted to do things normal, and I really cared about the way I looked when I did certain things. So for example, like opening water bottles, I was really self-conscious that I couldn't just twist the cap off. And so I tried to just twist the cap off of a water bottle, which this is empty, but it just doesn't work. The bottle will just spin. But anyway, after like the first year, I just started using my teeth and not really caring what other people thought about me, or I would squeeze it in between my legs and open it that way. But yeah, I think probably 2 years. My hair definitely took the longest to learn how to do, because I was in high school, so I was living at home with my mom at the time, and so she just did my hair for me, and I didn't really have to think about it. But the summer going into my sophomore year, I went and stayed in Alaska with my aunt and worked at Nordstrom. And so when I woke up in the morning, my aunt and uncle were already gone, so I pretty much was on my own to put my hair up. And so I finally had to just like figure it out. So in those 2 weeks or 3 weeks or 4 weeks, whatever, that month I spent in Anchorage, that's how long it took me to figure out how to put my hair up. All right, guys, that's a wrap for this Q&A. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any more questions after watching this, you can leave them for me in the comments or DM them to me on Instagram. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.